done. All right, guys. Hi to whoever's joining in for today's masterclass. Okay, so today's live, as you know, is about creating a soft glam, you know, using this new line of cosmetics. It's called C2P Pro. So basically, this brand, let me tell you a little something about it, is an upcoming brand, and you know, the cosmetics, the quality is really nice and they're very pocket friendly. So I have just washed my face and prepped it with this C2P Pro Ultra HD CTM face wash. So this is like a 3-in-1 face wash. It does you know, a lot of things. It just preps your skin for, you know, a nice makeup look. So I'm just gonna start in a bit. First of all, happy Lohri to everybody who's live with me here, who's watching this video. I have been waiting for some, you know, for such a thing to happen, for me to hold up a class for y'all. Hi, hello everyone who's just joined and, you know, who's been here. I have just set up everything pretty much. So we're just gonna start with the look. I'm just gonna start off with my eyes and we'll work our way through it. The reason why I start with my eyes first is because, you know, if you have any eyeshadow fallout, it does not bother your face makeup because you've not really built a base yet, so you can just, you know, kind of wipe it off. So you know, that's how I do it, despite of what a lot of professional people say, you know. So I'm just gonna begin with concealing my face with this amazing palette. This is a C2P Pro concealer palette. As you can see, it has a lot of shades in it, and this is good for cream contour as well because there are, you know, a lot of dark shades as well over here. So I'm just gonna start with this base shade here. I'm just gonna apply it onto my face. I am gonna grab a brush. Okay, this is something new that I've started doing. I have been using a flat brush, flat concealer brush till now, but now I started using this fluffy brush. It is a Real Techniques brush, and since it's fluffy, it kind of just blends the entire concealer in, and yeah, that's why I love it. So I am just gonna take this concealer and I'm just gonna use this one right here. Now I'm gonna start with creating a base. I feel that, you know, concealing your eyes before doing any eye makeup is very important because just because, you know, it just shows your eye makeup much better. So we're just gonna go ahead and blend the concealer nicely into the eye. See, so now my base is quite even here. You'll see, you know, like because of the base is not been put. If I put eyeshadow on this, it will not come out as pretty as it's supposed to. The colors don't come out as vibrant. So I have just taken some on my hand as well. So I'm just gonna blend the concealer right into my eyes. Not into my eyes, on my eyelids. Happy Lohri, Rishabh. This is a very low-key Lohri till now. Like, you've got plans, but let's see how it goes. What are your plans? What are you guys doing for Lohri? Do you do anything or you just don't? I mean, we usually go out, meet our friends, family, you know, celebrate. Alright, so I am done with the base of my eyes. Now, you know, these palettes are very, very pocket friendly, and you see the range of color that it brings, and it's actually pretty good and it's buildable. So, you know, that's something I really like about it. I'm gonna start off with the eyeshadow palette. Now, the eyeshadow palette as well, as you can see here, has a lot of pretty colors in it. So it has got nudes, it's got shimmers, bright colors, you know. It's basically everything you need in one palette, which is just amazing. So I'm just gonna start off. I'm gonna change the brush, of course. I'm just gonna take a nice eyeshadow brush and start blending in. I'm gonna keep this on my lap, much easier for me to work. So you know, one thing about this brand that I have discovered after starting using it is that the quality is really nice. It's basically built, the product has been made for, you know, professional use as well as personal use, of course. So you know, the products are not too light, they're not too heavy, and it's always, you know, everything is buildable, all the eyeshadows, the bases, everything, you know, is quite buildable. And the best thing, it's pocket friendly. So I'm just gonna start with a nude shade right here. I'm just gonna build up a base. I'm gonna place it right here. Okay, now building a base for your eyeshadows and eye makeup is pretty important. Because, you know, applying eyeshadow directly at your eyes, you know, something bright, something too dark, might just look a little uneven and, you know, abrupt. So it's always better to transit your colors using light and then going and working your way towards dark colors, you know. So yeah, I'm just gonna build a base right here. On my eye. Guys, please feel free to ask questions if you have any questions, any doubts, you know, anything that you want to know about makeup, because this is literally what I do every day, every single day, and yeah, I love doing it. So yeah, now I'm gonna dip into a darker color, but not with the same brush. I'm just gonna take a coarser brush that can hold the color in. I've taken this eyeshadow brush. It's basically a blending brush, but it's a very nice and coarse brush that, you know, you can just place the product with. So I'm taking this dark brown over here. Just gonna shake off, or, you know, like, just dust off extra and excess eyeshadow, because you don't want to apply it right there and see a big patch of color. Now I'm gonna start blending it very, very lightly on my outer crease. Okay, and let me tell you something about using brushes, you know. I think that a lot of people, you know, just go very close with the brushes. It's not needed. Just you know, like, hold it very light, like a pencil or maybe a pen, and kind of just swirl it on your eye. You know, this makes, you know, this application is the best way to apply, you know, an even eyeshadow on your eyes and not have patches and blotches all across. So I'm just building it lightly, just building the brown. When you start light, I think that, you know, you have that option of going darker, you know. If you start light, you can always build the color up. And if not, it's just fine, you know. If you like it light, might as well just stay light. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and do the same thing on this eye. Keeping a very light hand. Voila. And, you know, after I've done this, I like to kind of just sweep it across my eye, you know, like a little sort of a winged effect. It just kind of helps to elevate your eyes a lot. It just makes your eyes look bigger, look, you know, like, they just pop, which is an amazing effect. It's actually funny how, you know, makeup can just change your entire facial look. So yeah, I'm just gonna build this a little darker. I like the colors. I mean, I think I like the way it's turning out on my eyes. Hi Mansi, how you doing? And everybody else who's just joined in. Alright, so now I think I can take the dark color and kind of intensify the outer crease that I've made. For the inner crease, I have something really crazy, you know, that we can try. Again, for the outer eye, I'm just gonna use another brush again. I think it's very important that you keep changing your brushes for, you know, like, your eyeshadow looks, because if you use the same one, you can just end up mixing the two shadows and it would just be a whole mess altogether. Okay, so I'm just gonna dab it. Black is a very scary color to use, you know, so you wanna be a little neutral, kind of start light. Because black can mess eye makeups up like no tomorrow. You have no idea how many times I've fucked up makeups that have had, you know, dark colors in them. And then there's no going back. You just have to wipe it all off, start fresh, start from square one. So, you know, that's why I'm just going to lightly put this black, place it. Also on the inner corner, just a little bit. Like that. You know, it gives you a nice halo look. Right there. So what I've done is I've just placed the black eyeshadow on the outer corner. So now what I'm gonna do is I am just gonna take another brush, a blending brush, and I'm just gonna blend this out with a transition shade, which is right here. See? Voila. Now blending it out with another color, just make sure that, you know, it blends in with a nice shade and comes out to be another color altogether. I mean, of course it's black, but it has brown undertones in it. So I'm just gonna do this and blend it out. You see, the makeup right now is very raw. We are not done with the makeup yet, so of course it looks a little dull for y'all. But when the finished look is gonna come out, you guys are gonna love it, I'm sure. Now see, this time I took a little too much of black and I'll have to blend all the way out. Too much pain. Again, you know, like when you're working on the outer corner, make sure that you kind of, you know, just push it out to give it a nice elevated eye look. I'm gonna blend the inner corner as well. You don't want the color to be, you know, just being a big patch on your eye. Just make sure that you blend it out nice. Just like that. Alright, so this is done. I'm just gonna blend this out just a little more to make sure that, you know, we've achieved the right look. And if you find, you know, even a little bit of a patch on the outer eye, just pick up another blending brush that is lighter, like this one. It's not that coarse, you know, it's just a very light, nice blending brush. Pick up a lighter shade. No, I'm just gonna show it here. Pick the shade up and just kind of blend the corner out, because still you know, very dark outer corners look a little weird, and you know, that's one thing that, you know, differentiates amateurs from you know, professional makeup artists. It's what I've learned over time, you know. So after a lot of blending, you see, I blend a lot because these colors need to set in the right place. So, you know, with the blending, you can get that photogenic finish, you know, that that just out of the magazine sort of a makeup look. So, yeah. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a small crease here with the concealer from the same concealer palette that we used earlier. But this time I'm going to use a brush that is a little more precise to create, you know, the center. I'm going to use this brush by Kiko. It's a flat brush and it's really good for creating creases. There's another brush that I have which is really, really nice to create cut creases, but I cannot find it. It's just, look at this, I've got a huge set of brushes right here. There's just one set. It's very hard to find brushes in it. So now what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to go with this one. This is an angular flat brush. It's really good for creating cut creases. So I'm not gonna do a full cut crease. I'm just gonna apply a concealer in the center of my eyelid. Okay. I'm just gonna pick the concealer palette up. I'm gonna take the same shade that I set the base from, and I'm just gonna apply it right here. Now to intensify the concealer, I will just use my finger. Sometimes I just go very desi when it comes to makeup. See? So you can see the difference. And the eyelid looks a little elevated than this one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and fill it up. And then maybe just a little. Voila. And it's done. I feel like the whole look comes out nice when you conceal and, you know, like, make a facial base out of your makeup. Because, you know, till then, it's just all very bleak. Okay, another thing that I have just loved and I want you to see is their Duraline Mixing Solution. So, I'm pretty sure you do not know about this, but you should, you know, like, probably invest in one. So this Duraline solution, you can mix it with pigments, with eyeshadows, and make them intense. So I did not know about this until I came across this, you know, video on Instagram that, you know, a makeup artist had shown, which was basically, you know, mixing this with an eyeshadow, and the whole look just blew my mind. It just comes out very different. So I'm gonna use this to apply glitter here. A glitter pigment. You must have seen a reel, a very recent reel on my profile, which is about the C2P Pro pigment. This is a glitter pigment and it is beautiful. I love it. This is like my new favorite. If you can see, now I can apply it like this as well, but the effect's not going to be the same. I'm just going to take my finger and apply it just like that. It comes out nice, not bad, but now I'm going to mix the Duraline solution in this, just, you know, like one or two drops maximum. I'm just gonna do this. I'm gonna keep it. Okay, now I'm just gonna mix this up with a brush and I'm gonna apply it and I'm gonna show you the difference. You see, so now what I've done is the same amount of pigment, I've just put some Duraline solution in it. Voila. Now you just look at the film. Yeah, so you're gonna see right here. Look at the velvety finish. Can you see it? I mean, I can see it. Look at the difference. It's just beautiful, isn't it? I mean, the finish is just amazing. And I actually, one of my very recent posts had the same, you know, solution used. I use the same solution for it. Look at how different this pigment has come out after solutions. Guys, there's some... hold on, please. Giveaway go live. Good question, Muskan. I've just been in the middle of a lot of things right now. So even though I had thought about going live with the giveaway a few days ago, I've kind of held it for like this weekend. I think I'll go live with it this Saturday. So yeah, any other questions that anybody has, please go ahead and ask away. Okay, so I've left the lashes to dry off for just a smidge because I don't apply wet lash glue on my lashes. Till then, if you have any questions, let me hear them. If you have any doubts, anything else, just please feel free to ask. I see people joining in and I am glad. Hello everyone who said hi to me. I'm so sorry, I've not been answering. I've just been blabbering. Okay. So everybody who's joined in, a big wave to you. Khushbu, thank you so much for joining in and enjoying the live session. Okay, so I think it's been long enough for the lashes to go on now. I'm just going to blow air on them just a little bit. And I'm just gonna place it on my eyelash. I'm gonna show it to you. Right there. Now, you know, you can always see the difference between this one and this one. The makeup is just so much accentuated with the lashes on this one. Okay, somebody asked me a question. Just give me a minute to read. What, you didn't say the lids will lose powder. Is it necessary? I mean, see, my lids are not oily, so I do not set them with the setting powder. But if you have oily lashes or you feel like your makeup kind of moves here and there, then you can always go ahead and set. Plus, this concealer that I've used is like a thick base, you know. So, when you apply this concealer onto your lids, it will not budge. It will just not budge. So, it's not really needed. It depends on your eyes, on your skin type, and on the concealer that you're using. Had I used a liquid concealer, then probably I would have set it with the setting powder. So, I'm just going to set the second lash as well. The glue is still a little wet on this one. I'm a little scared of using wet, glue on my lashes. I love your eye makeup. I'm glad. Thank you so much. This is a very basic masterclass. I wish to hold up a few more professional classes with better makeup looks for y'all. And voila, I have just set the lashes right here. Okay. So I'm just going to look in the mirror because I feel like this one did not set right. Yep, it did not. You know, the issue with wet glue is that if it is not set, your lashes are just going to keep standing like that on the inner corner. So yeah, I am actually done with the lashes and with the makeup. Now I'm just going to go ahead and set my eyebrows, which do not need a lot of filling per se, but I still shape them, you know. So I am going to use, a flat precision brush for this because, well, why not? Voila, angular brush actually. I'm going to use an angular brush for this one. I'm going to pick these two shades right here because that's the mix of my eyebrow. I've got dark brows. I'm going to take a little bit of brown and a little bit of black. The lower brow line, then the upper brow line. And I'm just going to, you know, kind of blend it. You should always keep a lighter hand on the inner brow, I feel, because if it's too dark, it looks really bad and made up, and you know, you don't want to do that. So I kind of keep it light on the inner brow, and the outer brow, I make sure that I shape it right. Then I use a spoolie brush right here. This brush kind of blends and sets the colors and the brow powder right where it's supposed to be. You can see the difference, you know. Not a lot because of how my lashes already are, my eyebrows already are. But yeah, it kind of gives you a nice finish. I'm just gonna fill this one in as well. Ooh, this is a very pigmented brow palette, because one drag of brush and you know it's just set where it's supposed to be. I'm just gonna blend this out. Okay, so this is what the spoolie is for. I'm just gonna blend it out like this. So this helps. Wherever your eyebrow powder is sort of stuck, you can always use a spoolie brush and, you know, kind of set it where you want it. So I'm done with the brows and my eyes. We're going to start with the facial base now. For the face, I am going to use their foundation. Right here. It's an HD foundation and looks really good. The finish is really nice. It comes with a pump. You can, you know, just use this foundation once, and it kind of covers your, you know, imperfections to quite a big extent. You know, it's just amazing. Quite a great extent of my imperfections get covered with this foundation. So I'm just gonna pour it onto a palette, and I'm just gonna use it. Which brow palette are you using in it? So Khushbu, all the products that I'll be using in this video are C2P Pro. You can take a look at their page. I will actually just put a link up in the story soon. So these, you know, this brand is just really pocket friendly, really nice, and I personally loved the finish of these products. So I'm just gonna take a foundation brush. I use a kabuki brush because, you know, the finish is much better. Here's the foundation. I'm just gonna kind of dab it on and blend it. Look at this. Can you see the finish of the foundation? So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that on both the sides. Whoopsie. Right here. It just sets really well onto the face. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply some on my neck as well. The foundation shade, good question. I did not mention that. Just a minute. I am very clumsy, I keep dropping stuff, so please forgive the clumsiness. This foundation is, oh yeah, it's a warm nude 04, if you can see it. If not, I can always post the product details later on. Okay, so what's left is just my forehead and the neck. No, it's actually a medium coverage, medium to full coverage. It's buildable, so you can, you know, like, as I told you, this brand makes products for professional as well as personal use, hence all the products that I've shown you are buildable. You can, you know, use it for personal use or for professional use, of course. So I have just set the foundation. I'm gonna take a beauty blender right here, and I'm just gonna set it right onto my skin. Yes, this makeup is actually good for all skin types, because like, I actually, for one, have the worst skin in the world. I break out a lot. I have a lot of you know, pimples, and, you know, a lot of imperfections and stuff like that. So, you know, it's just, for me, if it's working, trust me, it'll work for everybody, you know, who's watching this. I have a very problematic skin, so, you know, it kind of, my skin doesn't kind, you know, like, agree with all kind of products, but this brand somehow is just really suiting me. So, oh my god, my hair are such a mess. I cannot get a control on them. I just washed them today, so thank you so much. Okay. So, once you've set the foundation, I'm just gonna go ahead and conceal my under eyes, because I have dark circles, like real bad ones. So, okay. I'm gonna use the same shade that I used earlier. With a concealer brush. Voila. So this is the brush that I usually use to conceal, but, you know, at times the fluffy brush works real well. So I'm just gonna apply the same shade under my eye that I did earlier on the eyelids. And it's very important that you kind of, you know, pull the concealer all the way up. This gives you again a very nice, you know, bright eye and, you know, big eyes look. This elevates your eyes a lot while giving your face a lift as well. You know, this is actually the fav my favorite part while doing makeup. I love to highlight and contour. It's just very beautiful. You get to play with the shape of your face. You get to play with, you know, what kind of glow you're going for that particular day. I highlight my face according to the lighting that I'm in. So yeah. Now, sure. Okay. So, मैं हिंदी में बोलना शुरू करूंगी because somebody has just pointed it out. Okay. तो अब ये कंसीलर लगाने के बाद, I'm sorry, I'm just not very comfortable doing this. मैं फिर से जो ब्रश मैंने पहले यूज़ किया था, उसी से I'm going to blend सारी फाउंडेशन प्रॉपरली. एक्चुअली इस ब्रश का जो बेस्ट पार्ट है वो ये है दैट ये कंसीलर को बहुत प्रॉपरली आपकी स्किन में सेट कर देता है. मैंने अभी एक एक वीक हुआ है मुझे ये टेक्निक यूज़ करते हुए, और मुझे ये यू नो लाइक बहुत ज़्यादा सूट किया है ब्रश. ओके और ये क्योंकि क्रीम कंसीलर है तो इसको ब्लेंड करने के लिए अगर आप छोड़ भी देते हो, अगर आप वेट करके अपना कॉन्टोर करने के बाद भी इसे ब्लेंड करना चाहते हो तो इट्स ऑलवेज ओके. आप वो भी कर सकते हो क्योंकि ये उन ड्राई कंसीलर्स की तरह, स्ट्रॉन्ग कंसीलर्स की तरह नहीं है जो यू नो आपने एक जगह लगाए तो वो सेट हो जाए. आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ सच कंसीलर्स जो ये बहुत यू नो बहुत थिक होते हैं, तो इसलिए उनकी कंसिस्टेंसी की वजह से वो जल्दी ड्राई ऑफ हो जाते हैं, तो उनको बहुत जल्दी एप्लीकेशन के बाद ही ब्लेंड करना पड़ जाता है. ओके आपने जब एक बार अपना फेस कंसील कर लिया, मैं अपने लिप्स के यू नो ऊपर और नीचे कंसील करना जरूरी समझती हूँ, बिकॉज मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि मेरा फेस यहाँ इतना एरिया मेरे लिप्स के पास थोड़ा डार्क एरिया है. आई डोंट नो वाई बस है, तो इसीलिए मैं यूजुअली अपनी अंडर आईज और अपने अराउंड द लिप्स एंड ऑन द साइड्स ऑफ माई नोज, अपनी नोज के साइड में भी कंसील करती हूँ. ये मेरे फेस के थोड़े डार्क थोड़े हाइपर पिगमेंटेड एरियाज हैं. ओके तो अब हम करेंगे कॉन्टोर. यूजुअली मैं क्रीम कॉन्टोर करती हूँ बट इट्स वेरी हैवी, मैं हैवी मेकअप में नहीं जाना चाहती. तो व्हाट आई एम गोना डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू यूज द C2P प्रो ब्लश एंड कॉन्टोर पैलेट अगेन. अब इसमें अगर आप कलर्स देखोगे तो इसमें पिंक्स हैं, न्यूड्स हैं और कॉन्टोर कलर्स भी हैं ऑफकोर्स. यू नो तो द बेस्ट पार्ट अबाउट दिस पैलेट इज कि इसके अंदर हाइलाइटर भी है. ये हाइलाइटर है, ये तीनों लाइक ऑल फोर ऑफ दीज आर सॉर्ट ऑफ हाइलाइटर्स और शिमर ब्लशेस. तो मैं पहले ये और ये दोनों कलर्स ब्लेंड करके, ब्राउन और न्यूड कलर को ब्लेंड करके कॉन्टोर करूंगी. ओके पिंपल को कैसे निकाल सकते हैं? यार पिंपल बड़ी प्रॉब्लमेटिक चीज़ होती है. पिछले पूरे 1 साल, नो 2 साल पहले मुझे बहुत ही मैसिव पिंपल प्रॉब्लम हुई थी जब मैं इंडिया वापस शिफ्ट हुई थी. तो उसका सिर्फ एक सॉल्यूशन है कि एक तो आप यू नो माइल्ड वो यूज़ करो, यूज़ अ माइल्ड क्लेंजर, फेस वॉश माइल्ड यूज़ करो. एक अच्छा टोनर यूज़ करो आपकी स्किन के लिए, क्योंकि यू नो लाइक टोनर से आपके पिंपल्स बैठने का बहुत चांस रहता है. मेकअप अवॉइड करो और यू नो जो भी चीज़ें जो आपके पिंपल्स को एग्रीवेट कर सकती है वो मत करो, बिकॉज माई इंटायर फेस, मेरा इतना फेस पिंपल से भरा हुआ था. ओके वाइल टॉकिंग आई एम जस्ट गोना कॉन्टोर इज वेल. तो हाँ कुछ बेसिक स्टेप्स हैं जिससे यू नो आप अवॉइड कर सकते हो पिंपल्स होना. ओके आई लव कॉन्टोरिंग, मुझे कॉन्टोर करना बहुत पसंद है क्योंकि यू नो उससे मेरे फेस की शेप बिल्कुल चेंज हो जाती है. इसकी ट्रिक यार हर एक की सेम नहीं होती है. अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल थिंक कि कॉन्टोर हर कोई एक जैसा करता है, बट ऐसा नहीं है. मेरा फेस ओवल शेप में है तो इस वजह से मैं हमेशा यू नो बहुत प्रॉपरली अपने चीक बोन्स और अपने जॉ लाइन को कॉन्टोर करती हूँ. मेरा जो फोरहेड है वो थोड़ा बियर्डली शेप्ड है, तो थोड़ा लंबा है, तो मैं यहाँ सिर्फ ऊपर कॉन्ट्रोल करती हूँ। आपके फेस पे बहुत बहुत डिपेंड करती है चीज़ कि आप किस तरह से कॉन्ट्रोल कर रहे हो। यू लव कॉन्ट्रोलिंग, ओके, बट कहीं सही से नहीं होता, बहुत प्रॉब्लम आती है। ओके, सी, कॉन्ट्रोल हमेशा स्टार्ट पाउडर के साथ करना चाहिए। डोंट गो विथ क्रीम कंसीलर्स, क्योंकि क्रीम कंसीलर्स जो होते हैं उनको ब्लेंड करना और उनको राइटली सेट करना बहुत मुश्किल होता है एमेच्योर्स के लिए, जो नए सीख रहे हैं, जिन्होंने नया नया अभी मेकअप करना शुरू किया है। हमेशा पाउडर कंसीलर्स, पाउडर कॉन्ट्रोल से शुरू करो, जैसा कि मैं यूज़ कर रही हूँ, और हमेशा यू नो ब्लेंड द टू कलर्स जो आप यूज़ करना चाह रहे हो, ठीक है। उसके बाद दूसरी चीज़, अपने फेस की शेप देखो इन द लाइट, और ये देखो कौन सी जगह पे शैडो पड़ रही है। आप जैसे आई एम सिटिंग ऑन द लाइट, तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो देयर इज अ डार्कर लाइट, यहाँ पे बिल्कुल ब्राइट दिख रहा है बिकॉज द लाइट इज दैट वे। तो जहां जहां आपको ये शैडो दिख रही है वहां वहां आपको कॉन्ट्रोल करना है। दिस इज द बेसिक ट्रिक, बहुत ही सिंपल ट्रिक है। हमेशा लाइट के सामने अपना फेस देखिए और आपको समझ आ जाएगा कि आपको कॉन्ट्रोल कहाँ करना है। मेरे साथ भी पहले कॉन्ट्रोल बहुत प्रॉब्लमेटिक होता था, मुझसे होता ही नहीं था, बट मुझे बहुत पसंद था कॉन्ट्रोल करना, क्योंकि मेरा फेस शेप चेंज हो जाता है कॉन्ट्रोल के बाद। बट इवेंचुअली पहले आई स्टार्टेड विथ, मैंने पहले जो है पाउडर कॉन्ट्रोल से शुरू किया, फिर धीरे धीरे क्रीम कॉन्ट्रोल से मैंने थोड़ा थोड़ा एक्सपेरिमेंट करना शुरू किया जब मैं काम नहीं कर रही होती थी या कहीं बाहर नहीं जाना होता था। अगर आपको अपना डबल चिन या यू नो नेक आपका बहुत हैवी है, या चिन डबल चिन है हैवी है, तो उसको सबसे अच्छा तरीका टक करने का, इंस्टेंट टक करने का है कि आप अपनी जॉ लाइन लो और उसके नीचे अपने ब्रश को ऐसे प्लेस करके ऐसे स्वाइप करो। सी, एंड यू विल सी एन इंस्टेंट रेजर शार्प जॉ लाइन। सो नाउ आई एम गोना डू इट ऑन दिस साइड एज वेल। वाला, सी, सो योर फेस इट लुक्स रेजर शार्प आफ्टर कॉन्ट्रोलिंग। अब मैं बस थोड़ा सा कॉन्ट्रोल अपने फोरहेड पे भी करूंगी, राइट हियर, जस्ट ऑन द टॉप। जिन लोगों का ब्रॉड फोरहेड होता है, बड़ा फोरहेड होता है, दे कॉन्ट्रोल पूरा ऑन द फोरहेड, ऑन द हेयर लाइन। बट दिस इज जस्ट मी डूइंग हेयर, लाइक कॉन्ट्रोलिंग हेयर, बिकॉज मेरा जो ब्रश का, सॉरी, जो मेरी स्किन का वो है, मेरी जो फोरहेड का शेप है उसको सही तरह से सेट करने के लिए मैं अपनी हेयर लाइन को यहाँ तक सिर्फ हल्का सा कॉन्ट्रोल कर रही हूँ, बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं। उसके बाद अब मैं सेम पैलेट में से ब्लश यूज करूंगी, एंड आई एम गोना यूज अ फ्लफी ब्रश। अच्छा, इसके जो कलर्स हैं पैलेट के, दे आर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल। आप कोई भी कलर यूज करो, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू रिग्रेट इट। आई एम जस्ट आई लव द कोरल कलर। आई एम गोना जस्ट मिक्स इट विद अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ पिंक एंड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ पर्पल एंड स्वाइप स्वाइप एंड स्वाइप। नाउ आई एम जस्ट गोना क्लीन द ब्रश। मैं सिर्फ ब्रश एक बार साफ कर लेती हूँ ताकि मैं अपने कॉन्टोर और ब्लश को ठीक से ब्लेंड कर पाऊँ। बहुत लोगों को लगता है कि ब्लश सिर्फ आपके एप्पल पे चाहिए होता है, द चीक्स, यू नो, जस्ट हियर द एप्पल ऑफ योर चीक्स, बट नो। हमेशा अगर आपने कॉन्टोर किया है तो ब्लश को हमेशा स्वाइप करिए ओवर द कॉन्टोर। एंड इसको अच्छे से अगर आप ब्लेंड कर लोगे तो आपका कॉन्टोर और ब्लश साथ में मिलके इट्स गोना गिव यू अ नाइस फ्लश ऑफ कलर्स ऑन योर फेस। ओके, तो मैं थोड़ा सा ब्लश अपनी नोज पे भी लगाती हूँ, जस्ट बिकॉज माई फेस एट टाइम्स स्टार्ट्स लुकिंग वेरी पेल, तो इसीलिए। ओके, अब ये करने के बाद व्हाट आई एम गोना डू इज, अब मैं अपने फेस को थोड़ा हाईलाइट करूंगी, बिकॉज वी आर गोना होल्ड ऑफ ऑन हाईलाइटिंग। बिफोर दैट मैं अपनी अंडर आई कंसीलर को सील करूंगी विद द प्रेस्ड फिनिशिंग पाउडर, दिस इज ऑल्सो बाई सी टू पी प्रो, ये सी टू पी प्रो का ही प्रेस्ड पाउडर है, बहुत ही फाइन फिनिश पाउडर है, इट्स अ वाइट पाउडर एंड इसकी सेटिंग बहुत अच्छी है, इसके बाद कंसीलर बिल्कुल नहीं हिलता, द कंसीलर डज नॉट मूव नो मैटर यू नो लाइक हाउ हैवी कवरेज कंसीलर यू आर वेयरिंग, इट जस्ट डजन मूव. सो व्हाट आई एम गोना डू इज आई एम जस्ट गोना पिक अ ब्रश. I'm gonna swipe this. Hold on. Okay. Everybody, I'm glad that you're enjoying this video. So I'm just gonna make sure कि मेरा concealer कहीं से crease नहीं हुआ है and I'm just gonna swipe the brush like this. इससे कंसीलर आपका एक जगह पे सेट हो जाता है और मूव नहीं करता. तो मेरे साथ ही कभी कभी प्रॉब्लम होती है कि यू नो अगर आप गर्मी में बाहर जाते हो तो क्रीज लाइंस बन जाती हैं विच लुक्स बैड मेकअप वाइज. तो इसीलिए मैं यू नो आई काइंड ऑफ मेक श्योर कि मैं अपना मेकअप सेट करूँ. वाला मेरा फेस एक कॉम्बिनेशन स्किन है तो मेरे फेस पे कई जगह पे ऑयली पैचेस हैं, कई जगह पे माय टी जोन इज अ लिटिल ऑयली, बट वैसे यहाँ मेरी स्किन थोड़ी ड्राई है क्योंकि बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्रीटमेंट दैट आई हैव टेकन फॉर द एक्ने. सो या नाउ वी आर गोना स्किप ऑन टू द हाइलाइटिंग बिट. तो अब मैं ये वाला हाइलाइटर यूज करूंगी, आई एम गोना यूज दिस हाइलाइटर ऑन टू माई चीक बोन्स. Right, so I'm just gonna swipe it across my cheekbone, just like that. मैं पहले फैन ब्रश यूज करती थी, आई यूज अ फैन ब्रश फॉर द हाइलाइटिंग बट नाउ आई स्टॉप्ड. बट या बिकॉज यू नो ये ज्यादा प्रिसाइज हाइलाइटिंग देता है फेस पे. सो या लुक एट दिस, द ग्लो ऑफ द हाइलाइटर इज जस्ट क्रेजी. I'm just gonna highlight my nose as well. Okay. Can you like see the concealer, like the sorry, the highlighter? It's just so pretty. Okay. Now. This brush has two sides. So this one I use for my brow line, like the below brow bone area. I'm just gonna swipe the highlighter across my brow bone. हाइलाइटिंग से आपकी ब्राउ बोन बहुत हद तक लिफ्टेड लगती है. So, you know, now you can see. This is just so pretty. No, C2P Pro is not available on Nykaa. ये Nykaa पे available नहीं है, but इनकी अपनी website है जिससे आप order कर सकते हो. और delivery भी काफी prompt है. तो, you know, I think order receive होने में भी shouldn't be a problem. It's still an you know emerging brand, but इसके cosmetics are actually pretty good. So yeah, now that I've finished my facial base, you can see the difference that I was talking about in my eye makeup. Also, it looks very glamorous and you know in very properly visible. Now I'm gonna go ahead with the lipstick bit. Now look at this. Look at this cute packaging. So this is a C2P Pro box that has about four liquid lipsticks. Yeah, look at that. So these are the four shades that it comes with. Brown, red, pink, and sort of a maroonish brown, you know. This package इट डज नॉट हैव वन सेट ऑफ कलर्स, मतलब इसमें एक ही टोन के कलर्स नहीं है, इसमें चार डिफरेंट टोन्स के कलर्स हैं. तो अगर आपको यू नो लाइक इफ यू वांट टू गो ब्राउन और लिटिल लाइट, दिस इज द कलर पिंक फॉर यू नो लाइक अ ब्राइटर लिप, डार्कर लिप, एंड देन यू नो द रेट्रो रेड लिप ऑफ कोर्स. सो आई एम, सिंस आई एम शोइंग यू अ सॉफ्ट ग्लैम लुक, आई एम गोना गो अहेड विद दिस वन. आई एम नॉट गोना डायरेक्टली अप्लाई इट ऑन माई लिप्स, आई एम गोना पुट इट ऑन अ पैलेट एंड यूज अ ब्रश. Okay, so now, hold on, I'm gonna look for a lip brush. My brush set is just a mess. It's a little hard finding brushes in a massive set like this. Found it, perfect. Okay, so for the lipstick, I'm gonna use a flat lipstick brush. I have taken scoops. Swatches of it, and now I'm just gonna apply it over my lip. Okay, now I sort of overline my lips just a little bit, not a lot, to give it the you know a perfect shape, the plump that it needs. Okay. Yeah, I'll go back to Hindi, don't worry. So जब भी लिपस्टिक अप्लाई करते हैं, मैं पर्सनली थोड़ा सा ओवरलाइन करती हूँ, थोड़ा सा लिप्स के बाहर लगाती हूँ, बट नॉट अ लॉट. अगर आप पास से देखोगे तो वो आपको वियर्ड नहीं लगेगा, बिकॉज ये सिर्फ पोस्ट के लिए नहीं है, ये यू नो रेगुलर मेकअप है जो आप बाहर यू नो जब भी जाते हैं तो यू वेयर इट. सो अगर अभी आप देखोगे मैंने बहुत माइल्ड आउटलाइनिंग की है, वाला द कलर इज वेरी प्रिटी, मुझे कलर बहुत पसंद आया. मेरे लिप्स लोअर लिप्स पे बहुत ज्यादा आउटलाइनिंग की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. So, I'm just gonna fill this in. So this is a nice brown, I like it. Okay. So, I know some of you are suggesting pink, but वो मेरे मेकअप के साथ नहीं जाएगा पिंक लिपस्टिक. और क्योंकि ये सॉफ्ट ग्लैम है तो इसीलिए आई एम स्टिकिंग विद यू नो लाइक अ मोनोटोन कलर. ये एक चॉकलेट ब्राउन कलर है. तो आई टेल यू वन मोर ट्रिक, एक ट्रिक जिससे आपके लिप्स डेफिनेटली यू नो प्लम्प और बड़े यू नो लगेंगे, कि आप कंसीलर लो, वेरी लाइट कंसीलर, थोड़ी सी कॉन्टोर क्रीम to mix the shade and match. और अपने inner lip पे लगाओ. इससे थोड़ा plump look आता है as you can see. और थोड़ा अगर आपको lip shade dark लग रहा है, मुझे थोड़ा सा dark लग रहा था तो I have used the concealer और मैंने उसको level कर दिया है. And I think this is the finished look. So this was the soft glam makeup look. और ये जितना makeup मैंने इस look को create करने में use किया है, that is C2P Pro. I will definitely put up a story जिससे आप लोगों को product details आराम से मिल जाए. और आई विल ऑल्सो शेयर अ लिंक जिससे आप इजीली यू नो अपना ऑर्डर अगर आप चाहते हैं प्लेस करना इन प्रोडक्ट्स का, तो आप उस वेबसाइट पे जाके वो कर सकते हैं. इनका बाकी तो यू नो एवरीथिंग इज रियली नाइस, बट इनके पिगमेंट्स बहुत 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 अमेजिंग हैं, आपको डेफिनेटली ट्राई करने चाहिए. लाइक आई हैव फॉलन इन लव विद देम. अगर आप इनको अच्छे से ब्लेंड करते हो ड्यूरोलाइन सॉल्यूशन के साथ, मिक्स करते हो जो मैंने आपको पहले दिखाया था इस सॉल्यूशन के साथ, तो ये पिगमेंट आपको एक फॉइल का फिनिश देता है, और आई डोंट नो अब कितने लोग यूज करते हैं फॉइल यहाँ पे. आई फॉइल्स होते हैं, दे लुक लाइक यू नो वेरी प्रिटी बिग चंकी ग्लिटर सॉर्ट ऑफ अ थिंग, बट बहुत लाइट होते हैं. यूजुअली अगर आप उन्हें यू नो परचेज करते हो तो वो थोड़े एक्सपेंसिव होते हैं, यू नो देर आर लिटल एक्सपेंसिव और आउट ऑफ बजट भी हो जाते हैं कई बारी. पर्सनली इवन आई फील दैट. बट ये जो पिगमेंट्स हैं बहुत ही पॉकेट फ्रेंडली हैं, एंड आप इनको इंडिविजुअली भी अप्लाई कर सकते हो और ड्यूरोलाइन के साथ भी अप्लाई कर सकते हो.